Many of us love eating good food. As fancy as the preps may look, and as delicious as they may be, they get digested once they enter into our system. And the body needs to throw the unwanted waste out in a day, failing which can cause illness. There is nothing in the world that can quench our thirst more and make us feel more refreshed than water. Yet if the body doesn't throw that water out in a couple of hours, that retained water can be the cause of illness. I once saw a very elderly yoga teacher teach her students breathing techniques. She asked them to breathe in and hold their breath. But elderly as she was, she happened to fall asleep. The students who respected her a lot were unable to hold their breaths any longer, but didn't even want to disobey her. Finally, as they were gasping, one of them walked up to her and woke her up. As she got up, she said, "And now, breathe out." As funny as this may sound, the air we breathe in can be held for no more than a few minutes. And if it's not thrown out, we may die. Isn't this principle true for our negative emotions as well? Emotional hurt, grudges, jealousy, feelings of hatred, revenge, anger can make our minds toxic. Yet we continue to hold them in our systems, only leading to so many psychological and consequently physical disorders. The body has a system to remove unwanted food, water, or air without us even being aware of it. How we wish there were an automatic arrangement that could throw negative feelings and emotions out as well. But that's not how it works with the mind. We have to consciously work on purging these toxic emotions out of our inner systems. And here are three suggested ways to get these feelings out. First, write your feelings down on a piece of paper and tear it into pieces or burn it into ashes. This practice doesn't necessarily solve the problem, but allows us to express ourselves and release the negative energy, at least temporarily. Second, open your heart and confide into someone close and trustworthy. Sharing our feelings can not only lighten the heaviness we feel, but we may also receive support and guidance to deal with our negativity. Third, the most powerful, of course, is adopting a spiritual practice, which can help us cleanse our consciousness and give us the inner strength to fight these tendencies. Always remember that it's not the glass of water, which is only a couple of grams in weight, that hurts our hand. It is the duration for which we hold it. The quicker we keep it down, the better it is for us.